You've heard the word blockchain thrown around in every crypto conversation, but what actually is it? How does it really work? Let's break it down. Welcome back to the Binance Studios. My name is Sami, and if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next one. First off, blockchain. What does it mean? Well, a blockchain is a digital ledger, but instead of being stored in one place, it's spread across thousands of computers. Every time a transaction happens, say you send crypto to a friend, it gets recorded on a block. When the block fills up, it gets locked, sealed with cryptographic proof, and linked to the one before it. That's what forms the blockchain, a chain of data blocks locked in sequence and nearly impossible to alter. So why does it matter? Because once that data is recorded, you can't just go back and change it. You'd have to rewrite every single copy on the network. That's why blockchain is known for immutability. Once it's in for good. And here's the key. There's no bank, no company, no middleman. Instead, a decentralized network of users verifies every transaction. That's right, every single transaction. Let's say Alice sends Bob some Bitcoin. That transaction gets broadcast to thousands of independent computers called nodes, who double-check it's legit. Once verified, it's added to a new block. That block gets a digital fingerprint unique to that block, referred to as a cryptographic hash, and is chained to the previous one. But to add that block to the chain, everyone on the network has to agree. That agreement is called consensus, and it's what makes blockchains secure and trustless. So how does that consensus happen? Bitcoin uses something called proof of work. Miners compete using raw computing power to solve a complex puzzle. The first one to solve it adds the block and gets rewarded in BTC. It's secure, but it's energy intensive. Ethereum, on the other hand, it now uses proof of stake. Validators are chosen based on how much ETH they've staked, like having skin in the game. No massive mining rigs, just commitment and capital. Both methods achieve the same goal: agree on the truth without needing a central authority. So what can you do with blockchain? A lot more than just send crypto. You can run smart contracts that execute automatically, create tokenized assets like real estate or art, build DeFi apps that replace banks, even secure digital IDs or voting systems, all using the same core principle: trust the math, not the middleman. Blockchain is already powering Bitcoin, Ethereum, and thousands of other crypto networks. It's what makes crypto work and why governments, banks, and even Fortune 500s are paying attention. But here's the big picture. Blockchain isn't just a new tech. It's a new way to build trust on the internet without needing someone in the middle. So, is it revolutionary or overhyped? Let us know what you think in the comments. And if you want more crypto breakdowns, fast, simple, and straight from the source, we have a full playlist for you to dive into. Subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss the next one.